The world is full of hungry people, and there's only a few inches of topsoil that feeds the whole world. If we let it blow away, wash away, how are we going to feed the world? Why wouldn't you want to keep that good soil on your farm? That land is expensive. You want to keep as much of it as you can. Five years ago, we adopted cover crop across the whole farm. The tilth of my soil is nice and loose and lacking of lumps. I'm using half as much fertilizer as I ever did before. I'm using half as much diesel fuel as I did before. And my yields have increased every year I've done this. All good things. It seems like the general thought is that the real benefits will show up about year 10. I felt I saw benefits the very first year. And now I'm 5 years in, and I'm excited to see what year 10 brings, if that's really the number. It's just been a progression upward every year.
Cover crops are one of those really great win-wins. It's good for the farmer, it's good for the environment, it's good for our rivers, lakes, and streams in that it helps keep water clean and good for the climate. It helps sequester carbon, it helps pull CO2 out of the atmosphere and put it back in the ground where it belongs. Here in the state of Minnesota, we've got a little over 17 million acres of farmland. Less than 4% of those acres right now are using cover crops. So we're really focused on making it easy and available for any farmer who wants to try cover crops. We want them to be able to do so easily.
The demand is really increasing in cover crop adaptation and use. So why aren't we seeing more cover crops in the landscape? I feel the biggest holdup as our industry is logistics. There was two bottlenecks going that we needed to take care of. One was not everybody has the equipment. The other bottleneck was getting the seed from the warehouse to the farm. That's what we are good at, making sure you get the right seed at the right time. If you need equipment, we can source it and find it for you. That's what we're really trying to help producers out with, to take that pressure off when he's busy harvesting anyways.
Fall's a busy time and we don't have any extra labor. So this year I had TJ come over here with his tractor and his machine, put the cover crops on my corn stubble. We first tried planting cover crops 3 years ago. Every year we've tried to add a few more acres. I'm working toward all of our acres. We are seeing soil health improve. We're seeing organic matter improve. We're seeing less erosion. When we used to plow and disc, we'd have these tremendous hard clods we had to work around. We're seeing the structure improve tremendously. This soil now is like garden potting soil.
There are a lot of different programs that growers can reach out to for the funding of the actual seed, but there is a need to build up the infrastructure and the equipment. I think that is the next step into wider adoption of these practices. Making sure that there are regional partners that producers can reach out to help with application timeliness, to help with speed of application, so that the barrier of time is no longer a liability for growers when they think about sustainability practices.
This is a big challenge, but I'm really looking forward to the day that cover crops and reduced tillage and other soil health practices are the norm. We're working with some really great partners, and we've got some really great farmers here in the state of Minnesota that I think we're gonna see that day hopefully sooner than we think.
I believe in soil health. I believe in improving water quality and not letting this fertilizer go down the Mississippi. I value that soil because I'm a third generation farmer on this land, and I think my son will be the fourth, and I don't know how far beyond that we'll go. I view soil health as the future. Cover crops build soil health, and that's what we need for the future.